Hey, been about 2 years since my last video, but here I am. Super quick before this one starts, I'll put more details at the end and in the description. But on this Friday, December 16th, a new Netflix cooking show comes out called Cook at All Costs, which I am a contestant on. Be sure to check it out on Friday. Check out my episode, check out the other episodes. Hope you love it.
Right, day 169 of guessing Eich's lunch, and it's Tuesday. And you know what's due on Tuesday? A little place called Chick-fil-A. Make you feel tasty. Chick-fil-A, locking it in.
Terrible pick, animal. Terrible pick. Listen, it's Tuesday. It's also quarterly reviews day. And Eich knows that his quarterly review is gonna look bad if he doesn't get Lenwich. Eich gets Lenwich or Eich gets fired. That's the end of it.
I'm gonna need Don's nation to rise up for this one. We're going international to a place across the Don.
Get him.
For that Donspiration.
Get him.
That Don Mitmit.
Get them.
That thing from Gordon Ramsay.
Go, get 'em!
Locking it in. Ike's getting beef welling Don's.
Of course, Judge Sexual Patterson is limited to 0 words today. Fucking Dave Portnoy wishes he were me.
Right, so today we're making beef Wellington. I'm going with the Gordon Ramsay recipe with some changes to make it easier and Americanized. If you haven't checked out BDGE on TikTok, definitely give him a look. That's what that intro was based off of. Huge fan, love the content. Don's is due every day. So there aren't a ton of ingredients in beef Wellington. There's the meat, the mushrooms, usually some sort of ham product, and puff pastry. That's really it. If you want to get too fancy with the sauce, you can. So there's not a ton of options for changing the price point other than just the meat. So I'm really just going to be working with 2 cuts of beef, and in the less expensive version, I'm just not going to use any ham whatsoever. I'm using prosciutto, some people use parma ham, maybe some people use agabagool. I haven't watched The Sopranos, so I don't know if that was accurate. So for my beef cuts for the cheaper version, I'm using eye round, which I'm going to cut to size to be the same as the original version. I'm gonna be using a tenderloin filet, which is just filet mignon. Now, my as of yet unnamed grocery store chain, which is famous for its delicious sandwiches and less than delicious political contribution history, doesn't carry filets in the full tenderloin size or even to the same size as the eye round. So I'm gonna do a little bit of creative cooking here. There is an inclusion of mustard in this recipe, which I think is take it or leave it. So I'm going to use that in the original, and I'm going to use it also in between these 2 pieces of filet to try and glue them together, and I'm gonna sear them together and hope that they get to a similar size. Once everything's wrapped up, no one's going anywhere. Great tagline for Durex. So we'll see how it works. And honestly, it might work out, it might not work out, we'll find out. But in my opinion, at the end of the day, a piece of meat doesn't need to be the perfect size to satisfy. Just ask any of my ex-girlfriends. Let's get started.
To make sure I get an even cook on these, I want them to be the same size. So I'm gonna pick up the fillets and do my best Kendall Jenner impression while slicing the eye round.
Now you can see these 2 pieces are roughly the same size, but there's obviously a big difference in the amount of exterior fat on them. I'm gonna clean this up and then glue these 2 pieces together.
Now that they've been cleaned up, I'm going to take some English mustard and paint the inside of each of these pieces. That should help them stick together when I sear the outside of the beef.
Now you still want it to be quite raw in the middle, so you're not doing it for very long, but you do want a nice sear like that. Now, once your inadequately sized meat has been browned on all sides, go ahead and cover it in plastic wrap and set it in the fridge to chill for about 20 to 30 minutes. So the mixture of mushrooms that's included in the beef Wellington is called duxelle. I got a C in French, don't know if I'm saying that right. It's basically just a whole shit ton of mushrooms chopped up super, super small and then cooked all the water out. You'll start kind of with a rough chop. It's a good activity to put your brain on like autopilot if you're not particularly concerned about having all 10 fingers.
This is the part in post-production where I remind you, this is much better done with a food processor. Don't use a knife, use a food processor.
So really when you get it down to about this size, you can kind of just go hog wild with the worst knife techniques anyone's ever seen. Now, one thing that's interesting about duxelle is you cook it with nothing in the pan, no water, no olive oil, nothing like that.
The point is to drive off all of the moisture from the mushrooms. So just add them in dry, just like my DMs.
At this point, you're really just cooking down the mushrooms to get as much moisture off as possible, but to add some flavor, you can add some thyme. It's totally optional. If you buy herbs in these plastic containers, it's the most overpriced thing in the grocery store by weight. This is completely skippable.
You know how some people will boil like whole oranges and sticks of cinnamon to perfume their house? This is actually a great way to do that too, if you're a bog witch and like really want the smell of the grave to just fill your home. I'm talking about you, Jinx Monsoon.
You can take the duxelle off the heat when it starts to look like a paste. If you use a food processor, it'll look a lot more like a paste than mine does right now. We can move on to the puff pastry. I'm just gonna lightly flour a work surface. If you have a rolling pin, roll it out. If you don't, just stretch it out to about a good sized rectangle. Once you're done with the puff pastry, you can start laying out a layer of prosciutto onto a sheet of plastic wrap. That's assuming that you bought high quality prosciutto and not the cheapest one in the store like I did, which rips apart every time you try to get a piece.
Jif brand duxelle of chunky, not smooth. And just paint the outside with our mustard.
Place the meat down in the center of everything and grab the edge of the plastic wrap to roll it up, making sure to get the worst camera angle of all time.
This did not work out the way that I wanted it to. Oh, I'm gonna make a YouTube video about how to make cheap beef Wellington, and even for the expensive one, I'm gonna buy the cheapest prosciutto the store has. What's wrong with me?
Once you've figured out your prosciutto emergency, take the plastic wrap and roll the Wellington out into a log, which you'll then put in the fridge to chill for about half an hour. After that, put it on the puff pastry and put down an egg washer on the edges to help it stick when you fold it all up.
Put this on a plate and chill for 5 minutes.
If you're a brain surgeon or just good at cooking, you can give your Wellington a light scoring on the outside, finish it with a sprinkle of salt, and then put it in a 400 degree oven for about 15 to 20 minutes. Once it's done, take it out and let it rest for 10 minutes before cutting into it.
Pretty easy to see which one is the nicer version, this one here, that has the meat in the wrong direction. You know, here we can see we have the eye round and just the duxelles. Here you can see, maybe you can't see, I don't know, but there's prosciutto in there. Let's give it a shot. So we'll go with the classic first.
Mmm.
So it's definitely a touch overdone for my taste, but it's still incredibly tasty. You know, I was concerned because I didn't season the meat. The prosciutto really lends that salt that you want. And the mustard is truthfully undetectable for me, so you could skip it. All right, let's go for the cheaper version. I'm seeing an issue already. A lot of the puff pastry is not really cooked through. I think there was a lot of moisture from the beef that leaked into the pastry and kept it from crisping and cooking all the way. All right, this is a little more what we're used to seeing. My knife's over there. You know, I hate to say it, but I think this is a recipe that benefits from investment in it. The absence of prosciutto is a big problem. It really does contribute not only as a source of salt, which obviously you can get around by just salting the meat, but as a barrier to all this liquid. On top of that, this cut of meat is just too tough. It takes so much work to chew through this, which is only made worse by gummy pastry. This is unfortunately one I gotta say, spend the money for. You know, if you go splurge for the filet, go for it. If not, I would see what other options are out there. Come up with anything, I'll put them in the description. Similarly, I think you should go for the prosciutto. Going for a nicer prosciutto is obviously gonna be more expensive, but I think benefits you. It'll be cut in a way that makes it a lot easier to make that seal. Yeah, I went for the cheaper prosciutto and it was harder to separate and make it so that I could really envelop the meat in that. This one's hard to make budget, really, I think it is. What I would do to make this a little more budget friendly, if you're going to entertain with it, don't make it the main course. I would make this an appetizer. Get puff pastry, you know, one filet, and maybe one package of prosciutto, and bake it in muffin tins, and have it be like a little, but even just cooking it as a cup could be work, and by breaking it up, you can make it, just in terms of your bottom line expenditures, much more budget friendly. But if you're gonna make it the main course, this is just one that's hard to make budget friendly. It's also one to make hard diet friendly for me, because now I have to eat two whole beef Wellingtons. Try my best, Gordon, but you one-upped me this time. We both know what I am.
Do luxury ingredients always make the best dishes? Or can humble items be transformed into a recipe for success? This is Cook at All Costs.
I need something.
With $25,000 in their bank, three home cooks will have to bid on all their ingredients.
I'm ready.
In a high-stakes, auction-packed cook-off.
$5,000.
Sold!
The home cooks can spend big for the best ingredients, save their money for the basics, or gamble on a surprise.
Chicken hearts.
In the end...
Whoop. Here I come.
Oh. The winner will go home with all the cash left in their bank.
Oh, man.
The back pantry is home to the hottest names in today's culinary world.
Surprise!
These celebrity chefs will prepare the mystery boxes, ingredient temptations, and judge the dishes.
You gotta make mama happy.
All right, chef, send out those boxes.
It's the ultimate cooking competition where skill meets strategy.
Let me get my buzzer fingers ready.
This is Cook at All Costs.